Let's now take a closer look at those switches we were talking about in an earlier module. Switches connect devices of the same network together. They can connect into other switches and routers as well. Switches and PCs connected between router interfaces are considered to be on the same network. When a PC sends an Ethernet frame into a switch, the switch checks the destination MAC address to see if it knows which interface that MAC address is connected to. If the switch knows where the device with that MAC address is, the switch sends it out just that interface. If the switch doesn't know where a destination MAC address is, the switch floods the frame out of all interfaces except the interface on which the frame originated. So now the obvious question is, how does the switch learn where MAC addresses are in the first place? The switch actually starts off knowing nothing, but as frames are sent into the switch starts learning. If host A sends a frame for host B into the first interface on the switch says, aha, I know that the MAC address of host A can now be associated with the interface on which it was heard. The switch will make a note of it through a table in memory called SAT, Source Address Table. Since the switch doesn't know where host B is, it floods the frame out of all the interfaces except the one the frame originated on. When host B replies, the frame goes into the switch, and the switch learns that host B can be found on the second interface. The switch then adds the MAC address of host B and the interface it was heard on into its source address table as well. The logic works the same for switches that are connected together. Each switch maintains its own source address table. You'll notice that hosts E, F, G, and H are known to switch to on interfaces 1, 2, 3, and 4, respectively. But as far as switch 1 goes, hosts E, F, G, and H are all accessible through interface 5, which connects to switch 2. Hosts A, B, C, and D are known to switch 1 on interfaces 1, 2, 3, and 4, respectively. But as far as switch 2 goes, hosts A, B, C, and D are accessible through interface 5, which connects to switch 1. So if host C sends a frame to host E, it goes into switch 1 on interface 3. Switch 1 consults its source address table and realizes host E is accessible out of interface 5. Therefore, switch 1 sends the frame out of interface 5 where it's picked up by switch 2. Switch 2 now looks at the destination MAC address in the frame, which is still the MAC address of host E. In an earlier module, we learned that routers reframe packets at each hop. Switches, on the other hand, are transparent and don't change a single part of the frame. After consulting its source address table, switch 2 sends the frame out of interface 1, where host E gets it. In addition to flooding unknown unicasts when the switch doesn't know where a destination MAC address is, the switch will also flood multicasts and broadcasts out of all interfaces. Remember, all ARP requests are broadcasts. If there are 20 connected switches in a network, with 20 PCs connected to each of those switches, a single ARP request will be read by 400 PCs.